Hey everybody, Saturday night game night. I have no idea what was going on. I don't YouTube glitch. I have no idea. It's always 8 p.m. And I look down and I'm like going, what the heck? 29 more minutes? No, that's wrong. But hopefully people will start flowing in and I will come right back after this intro. Woo!
Just me, or is it getting crazier out there?
Hey everybody, welcome to Light Late Horror Show. I'm Dino. As always, it's Saturday night game night, and we've got trivia tonight. Maybe next week we'll be captioning this. I'm not sure yet. But hello to each and every one of you. Peter says right away, "Hi Dino. I might be terrible at this one, but I am going to try." Yeah, listen. I originally had Suspiria. Okay. I wasn't ready for Suspiria, but I was ready for An Old Dark House. And I love this movie so much. It's probably in my top 10, 15 of all time. I love this movie so much. I can't even tell you. I've got a story behind it from on the channel. Me and Ted did a full commentary on it. One of the funniest streams we ever did, because halfway in the middle, we're live. Ted had to go to the bathroom. And he says he whispers it because we're live on it. I think I gotta go to bed. It was the funniest thing ever. I said, go. But anyways, we are going to do an old the old dark house. The old dark house. And I know, classic horror. If you do good, you do good. We're all going to have fun. There's some questions in here that are easy for even somebody that just might not know a lot about it. And then there are some that hopefully you've seen the movie and kind of remember it. But let me say hello to everybody. Also, remember to hit the thumbs up button, you guys. Hit that bell if you're watching it and you're not subscribed. Go, man, this is good. Hit that, all that stuff. Description below for all the links. A lot of interesting things to talk about, but let me say hi to everybody in the chat. Hey, John Swan, MOR, what is going on? One Sean Bond, good to see you. Connie Clary, WWM, Francis McCloskey, present and hung over. Hung over what? What are you hung over? She's present, but you hung over. Oh, you're party, party. Anyways. Who else is here? Peter Awernicki. Love this intro. Thank you. I'm working on something. I'm not sure if I'm going to change it. I don't think I can. It's classic for the channel. But anyways, let's see. Who else is here? I know Black Roses was here. Anyways, as you guys come on in, we will keep it going. But I've got a list of questions here. Some of them are easy, some of them are hard. I just wanted to sit here casually and have a good, nice trivia night with you guys and see how many people know An Old Dark House. So they're a little bit different, these questions, as I'm going to present them to you. There are no ABC. Oh, pardon me. Jeez. There's no ABC or D, but there are, you're going to need to know the answer. And again, typing in the best you can, just so I understand that you know who you're talking about or what you're talking about. But yeah, this should be fun. This movie, I mean, I'm not going to get too much into it because we're going to do trivia, but it is such a good film. Atmosphere, everybody who played in it, it's just a classic. I've been on an old movie kick lately. So you might start getting some classics, especially coming up towards Halloween. You might start getting some older classic stuff. So, which I guess is usually what you get on this channel anyways, right? But love both versions. There you go. Did Dino call me a she? Did I, Francis? Sorry very much. Because I know you're not. Anyways, hungover though. That's what's going on. Anywho, yeah, I don't know how the heck YouTube got that screwed up. Maybe it was me. I don't know. It could have been. But yeah, what else can I tell you? Me and Dave Plouffe tomorrow night, we are going to be talking about Art Bell, Ghost to Ghost 1996, continuing on with the Coast to Coast shows that we're doing. So that should be really fun and interesting. Hello, Sears James. I've got to go and talk to get a hold of a couple people to come on the stream next week sometime. So I'm going to have to figure out a day. Marley 92, love the old dark house 1932. So do I. Enough said. Anyways, hopefully you guys checked out the creepy pastas I've been putting up. The last one was almost a half hour long, so they're getting longer. I'm putting more time into making them longer, so hopefully you you enjoy it. All coming from this brain right here in imagination, and you know, as with anything, you know, some are better than others, but hopefully you guys enjoy it. What else is coming up? And that's it for right now. Let's get to trivia night tonight, Saturday night trivia night. We've got 18 people here, so we're rocking. We're rocking. Anyways, let's get to the first question. How about that? Love the creepypasta, Tino. Thank you, Connie. Appreciate it. So the first question I got for this, and again, be ready to type because some of these are easy. Like the first question is going to be an easy one, okay? And here we go. First question. Who directed The Old Dark House? Come on. And the answer, please. Probably the easiest question of the night, I would think, but iconic, and his works, the person's works, yeah, I know, the too easy, Paul Hamm, but you know, I'm throwing it out there. Yes, James Whale. James Whale is just, his cinematography, his experimentation with the film and the process just lended a certain ambiance and feel to all of his movies. I don't want to give any more away, but you know, because later on, anyways. James Whale, one of the greats, I do believe passed away way sooner than he should have. There were reasons for that. I won't go too deep into it, but there you go. James Whale. Am I saying that right? Marley 92. Hopefully I'm saying that right. But yeah. Today is Saturday night, trivia, game night. Paul here, I'm out. Paul's here, I'm out. No, let's have some fun. Okay, let me go to question number two. Sweet Indigo 45. Good evening, Dino and everyone. Good to see you, Sweet Indigo. Good to see ya. Anyways, here we go. Does anybody out there have an Oculus, a VR headset? If you do, let me know. That's all I want to say. If not, you guys should invest. We could all hang out late at night. It's just Marley. I'm trying, man. Marley. Okay. Anyways. Okay. So Paul Hamm's got the first point. Okay. Maybe a little bit different. Harder. Here we go. Next question. Let's see how much you know this. Not me. I have one. No. I have one. WWM. WWM, please. You're on Discord, aren't you, WWM? If you're on Discord, I've got a VR section, but I'm going to be putting, I'm going to ask everybody on there too, but I go on VR every night on big screen, and it'd be cool to have some of you guys to hang out with. We could all have a party after the party or during the party. I could play my stream up on the big screen while we're all out and about talking to each other and having fun and getting to know each other. I think that would be really cool. So I'll do that on Discord. I won't waste time here. So the next question you might need to know about The Old Dark House for, but which novel is The Old Dark House adapted from? Which novel is The Old Dark House adapted from? People. And let me know. And I'll be letting you guys know too soon. Dude, I'm going to be having a... I've got a book coming out. And it'll be on Amazon very soon. So I will... little information. I'm working from morning to night. So hard. So anyways, let's see. See, man, I tell you. Look at that. Arnaldo Biscaro. Greetings from Argentina. Good to see you, Biscaro. Welcome, welcome, welcome. And it looks like Paul Ham. Okay. He knows his old dark house, the Castle Kafka. Horton hears a who. yes, it is benighted by J.B. Priestley. J.B. Priestley. So Paul Ham with his second point. Listen, you guys are going to get, I have a feeling there are questions in here that it shouldn't be the Paul Ham show tonight. There should be some questions that you guys can get, but Paul Ham, 2 points, man. Good job. But yes, announcement, got a book. Anyways. Next question. Here we go. I'm going to keep it going. And some of these are hard. So here we go. Who played the character Philip Waverton in the movie? And I have these questions because it's a star-studded small cast. So you guys who really know the movie should know most of these actors and actresses. So who played the character Philip Waverton in the movie? It's a famous name. You should know it, but yeah. Boom, boom. It's out of my reach. Anyways, MR. Oh, wait, no. Peter got it first. Look at that. Then MR and then WWM. So Peter, awesome, got a point. Yes, it is Raymond Massey. Raymond Massey plays the character Philip Waverton in The Old Dark House. Way to go. Again, a star-studded cast, all performed awesome. I just can't get enough of this film. So 1 point to you, my friend. He goes, oh my God, I got a point. Oh my God, I got a point. What's the point, Peter? What is the point? Good job. Massey, Connie Clary says. Okay, let's move on. Listen, I got a lot of questions. Let's keep moving. Keep them moving. Oh, God. Get ready, people. Come on. Get ready. Here we go. Which iconic horror actor played the mute butler Morgan? Okay, who's fast? Which iconic horror actor played the mute butler Morgan or Ivan from the... No, I'm joking. From The Most Dangerous Game, Ivan. Same characters. Anyways, dang, I have a delay on posting, but I can live with failure. It's all right, Marley. Yes, Paul Hamm. There you go. Paul Hamm. Oh, Black Roses says Torg Johnson. No. Lon Chaney. Hey, WTF. What's going on? Karloff, Connie Clary, John Victor. Hey, John Victor. What's going on, man? Karloff, Karloff, Boris Karloff, Boris Karloff. Yeah, so Paul Hamm with his third point. Yes, it is Boris Karloff. See, some of these are going to be so simple, they're ridiculous, is what they are. Angela Lansbury says, Mr. McCloskey. Hey, CM, what's going on? Good to see you tonight. Yeah, Boris Karloff, very, very easy. But yes, it could be the same as Ivan from The Most Dangerous Game. Same look, same, you know, all that good stuff. Anyways, yeah. Never seen the movie, says Black Roses. If you're on this channel, you should know. You need to watch this. Black Roses. Hey, Night Fright Talk Show. I think I said hi to you. But Paul Hamm, congrats. Yes, and The Old Dark House is one that everybody should see. It should be, I don't know if it's on like the top 100 movies of all time. Probably not, but it should be. It should be. James Whale, one of the greatest directors of that time, didn't do enough, could have done more. But what he did, I mean, geez, come on, people, get to the facts. Okay, so next question. Let's keep it going. Let's keep it going. Let's see. Okay. What do the film's protagonists seek shelter from at the beginning of the movie? What do the film's protagonists seek shelter from at the beginning of the movie? So easy. If you've seen it, this movie is kind of sexy for its day. Yes, Francis. Yes, there's a couple characters, the two female protagonists in here. Just, mamma mia. Look at what is going on to Peter. Peter Wernicke, yeah, look at that. Yes, yes, I will go with that. It is a storm. Yes, it is a storm. Listen, all of that stuff happened during the storm, the floods, a mudslide, a rainstorm, all of those. But yes, Peter Wernicke came in first with a storm for his second point behind Paul Hamm with three. Congratulations. And I do have water this week, so I can sip. Let's see. Can I sip it real close to the mic? It's called pre-code. What? Are you new to this channel? Are you new to this channel, Marley? I think you are because I haven't recognized the name before. But yeah, we all know pre-code. This channel is about old horror. I just did a review discussion on The Most Dangerous Game, pre-code. So, yeah. Anyways, mamma mia, that's a spicy meatball, says a CM. Huh? What you do? What you say? Huh? Good job, Peter, with another point. Peter, get to eat. I can't come up with nothing. Anyways, keep it down outside. What are you doing? Cool, refreshing water. Oh, water. That cool, refreshing drink. What is it? Lemonade. That cool, refreshing drink. When film was smelly. Are you talking about the vinegar syndrome debacle that killed half of the frickin' films of the silent era in the 30s and damn them. Well, it's not their fault. They just didn't know. Didn't mean to sound snarky, Marley. No, it's all right. It's all good. But yes, this channel is about classic. Well, it's about old time radio shows. But it's about old movies, classic movies, whether it be classic from the 80s, 70s, 30s, silent, whatever. Oh, tonight too, I decided it feels like a Sherlock Holmes night. So tonight is a Sherlock Holmes night. So get ready for a nice Sherlock Holmes stream overnight, all night long. When I get in the mood for it, I'm going to play it. So there you go. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the past few days to the week. I mean, these have been some really great cleaned up and I'm streams that I'm putting out there. So hopefully you guys really dig it. Postcode. Yeah. Even postcode horror movies or movies in general. So we do the pre-code, the postcode. Yeah. Anyways, next question. I won't keep you in suspense any longer. No, Mr. Holmes. Which one am I on here? Let's see. Okay. Here we go. I know everybody's not going to know this. Which actor played the role of Sir Roderick Fem? Which actor played the role of Sir Roderick Fem? At least see if you guys remember any of these actors or actresses' names. But yes, which actor played the role of Sir Roderick Fem? Let's see. The Great Panicker is here. Loving the streams, kind of clear, says. Hope I haven't asked this already. But how do you create the awesome thumbnails for the 10 or 11 hours old time radio horror compilation vids? Thanks. The thumbnails, it's put together in many different ways through Adobe. It's, as you've noticed, it's the thumbnails are evolving into something different as I learn different skills when it comes to art and the creation of art and all of that good stuff. So the thumbnails the past 7-10 days, something like that. If you notice, I'm saying I love the style that I've created and walked into here. I take pride in that. So there you go, The Great Panicker. But it's all a process, you know. Sit down, or it can take me 15 minutes, usually, sometimes 20. It depends. Depends how deep I get into it. But let's see, who got the question? Somebody block Democrats. Yeah, somebody block that. Anyways, you stupid idiots. Serious James, you got high praise from the almighty and powerful Steerpike Dino. Awesome. I listen, high praise from Steerpike is good. I appreciate that. Marty Feldman? No. Peter Wernicki? Listen, I think Peter is prepared tonight. Peter is prepared tonight. It is Elspeth Dudgeon. Elspeth. So tied up 3 points each with Paul Hamm and Peter. Peter, good job, man. Sir James Melvin Douglas. Let's see. It was a woman. Shh. Don't say nothing. Did somebody block Democrats? Okay, thank you. Yes. Need to go. Yeah. Hide that user. Thank you. What a friggin'. Hey, Kathy, big hugs to you. What's going on? Miss you. I miss a lot of you guys in movie nights. Believe me, bear with me. I'm getting back to it. But listen, there's times in our lives where we go through stretches of things that either we all deal with stuff. We all deal with stuff. I'm open about most of what I deal with in life, whether it's phobias, anxiety, or panic attacks, which, you know, I'm very open to you guys about all of that. So needed to step away for a while from even those simple things, even though I can get on here right now and do this. as you've noticed, it's been like a two streams a week thing, and I've been doing the creepy pastas, which I hope everybody likes, but I do miss you guys in movie night. And very soon, if not next week, if not, I know I keep saying every week, next week, we will get back to things and even bigger and better and more. So there you go. But I do miss you guys. We'll see how many people actually come over there, because I think I'm going to actually put some more streams up on Patreon and for the channel members too. That'll be in the future. We'll talk about it. So good job, Peter, man. Peter, the man with the bird feeder. Okay. So with that said, much love to each and every one of you. So let's go on to the next question. Yeah, I don't want to get into the character played by Elspeth because, yeah, what's creepypasta? Oh, if you see creepypasta in my stream, they're horror stories. I've been creating horror stories, and they're usually creepypastas. That's the Gen X term for creepypastas, but they're very, very popular, which is why I call it a creepypasta, because technically it is. They're technically also a short horror story narrated. That's basically what they are. I did create Detective Johnny Ryder. I'm not sure if people want me to continue with that. I did a series of like 5 episodes, I think. But maybe the next season will be coming soon. But anyways, yes, I love the creepypastas, Dino. Awesome, Kathy. Listen, that's coming straight from my mind. So, I mean, I hope everybody is really enjoying it. It is not narrated by me, but because I don't think I'd read the narration as well. I just don't. A couple people said it would be nice to have your voice narrating. I'm going to try. I think the next one I'm going to try to narrate it myself, but there's nothing like the voice I got up there right now. I like that old British kind of voice for the narration, but anyways, it is what it is. Is it a play on spaghetti westerns? Listen, Francis, I think you know what they are. Come on. You're a creepypasta Greek. Food for the soul, Dino. Thank you, Sirs James. I appreciate that. Short standalone horror stories sometimes in experimental formats. Yes, WTF. Dino, those are good. Thank you, John Swan. You got a twisted mind, LOL. Kathy, you don't know that already? You should know that already. Come on. You got to do it, man. Narrate it. I may go ahead and do that. I'll try the next one, see what's going on. John Swan, you got it right. Definitely. There are programs out there that can do some narrations for you and stuff like that. So it's better than my voice, but I'm going to try my voice next time. How about that? So next question. Because we got a tie between Paul Hamm and Peter Wernicke with 3 points each. Is it a play on spaghetti westerns? You. Okay. Here we go. They're great. Must hear, Francis. Sweet Indigo. Thank you, Sweet Indigo. I appreciate that. I really do. And listen, they're not doing bad. Listen, the channel is about old time radio shows and the streams overnight. And I love doing that for you guys. And I do it for many different reasons. For all the people who are, like I said, we've seen emails, and I've talked about this before, who are ill in bed, who can't sleep, who have tinnitus, who are going through cancer. Our good friend, rest in peace, High Boy Donuts, Dennis, RTN Productions. He was here as long as he could for 3 years. And, you know, this was his family. And this is where he was every night. And it helped him get through the nights, the long nights of the stuff that he dealt with. So there's many people out there like that. And that's what the overnight shows are for. But anything else that I try is me just trying to have fun, like the reviews, the trivia nights like this, the creepypastas or short horror stories. You know, these are all things with me tinkering around a bit and having fun. And just if you don't change things up on your channel, it's just it'll slowly decline and die and stuff. So you got to constantly keep new and, you know, improving, changing. So that's what I do. Next question. Yes, we all miss RTN. And again, the thing I say all the time is, Dennis will always be, RTN Productions will always be a part of this channel. You can go back to all the older streams that you like and watch the chat as you're listening for maybe the first hour or two and watch RTN go off in his funny little things he says and stuff like that. They're still there. Every chat is saved and it's like a time capsule. That's what I love about that. Let's see. Stairpike said this channel is a magic place, Dino. Thank you, Sirs James. And Stairpike. Yeah, high praise. Please do your voice, Dino. I will try, sweet indigo. I'll make a fool of myself, I think. But anyways, okay, here we go. There we go. Harry Scott. Yes, he's summoned, I think, by our old friend. Yes, Donald Duck Applejuice. Okay, next question. Here we go. Might be a little bit harder, but here we go. How is Horace Femme related to Rebecca Femme in the film? How is Horace Femme related to Rebecca Femme in the film? I go back and do that, Dino, just to see RTN in the chat. Awesome, Kathy. Yeah, see? I do that too. I do that to see a lot of people that used to be part of the channel. It's interesting going back 3 years ago even and seeing who was in there and people we connected with and were close with. It is very, very cool. Okay, let's see who got it first here. Paul Hamm, he is her brother. He is her brother. Horace is Rebecca Femme's brother in the movie. So 4 points to Paul Hamm. Peter has 3 points. So there you go. Fifth cousin, CM. She is her sister. Fifth cousin, mother. I love you guys. You guys are great. Even if you don't know the answer, you make it fun. You make it funny. And I would say do that. Francis comes in late with uncle. Okay, next question. I don't want to keep prolonging some of these questions. Next question. Okay, well, should I do this question? Because it's a little complicated. Hold on. Okay, I think you guys will get this because somebody kind of mentioned. So type the answer as best you can. Here's the question. The question is, what is unique about the portrayal of the character Sir Roderick Femme in the film compared to the book? What is unique about the portrayal of Sir Roderick Femme in the film compared to the book? As you noticed Sir Roderick Femme up in the bedroom, listening to that laughter. So anyways, let's see what you guys will come up with as for an answer, because it's quite simple. Yeah, there you She's a lady. What's that song? She's a lady. More than a woman. More than a woman to me. WWM gets the point. Sweet and to the point. Okay. Let me read this a little. He's really old in the movie, over 100. Oh, yeah. It's a man in the book, okay? Sir Roderick is a man. In the film, the character is played by a woman, though, in the movie. Played by a woman, but a male, pretending to be a man. I mean, you see the prickers and so, but it was played by a woman in the film. So it's just very interesting. Very interesting. So yes, she's a lady. So in the book, he has a wooden heir, Sisium. So congrats, WWM. It's in the third person. Let's see. Listen, I love reading these. Okay, hold on. Woman. He's a Black Roses. Come on. Male impersonator playing him. Paul Hamm. Not crazy. It's in third person. Yeah, okay. Dude looks... that's another one. Dude looks like a lady. Well, dude looks like a male, but is a lady. Dude looks like a male, but is a lady. I don't know. So yeah. Anyways, good job, WWM. And I will move on to the next question. Well, way to go though. You guys answered it. I thought that was a little complicated worded, but you guys did good. Okay. So here we go. Actors and actresses, who played the part of Gladys Duquesne Perkins? Who played the part of Gladys Duquesne Perkins? Mwah. Anyways, Victor Victoria. It's Lola. I was thinking of that series. Okay. Yeah. Let's see who's got this. Who's got this? Come on. Beautiful. Beautiful. Lillian Bond, says Peter. Nope. Wrong one. Wrong. Up. Come on, you guys. It's not Lillian Bond. Not Lillian Bond. Everybody said Lillian Bond. Hold on, you know, I could get wrong, but keep going. I think it's, no, I, hold on. that's not the correct answer unless I'm wrong. Let me look. The old, Groucho Marx, you did say Gladys, right? Yes, Gladys Duquesne Perkins. Okay, I'm sorry, I'm looking. I don't know how I could have gotten that wrong. But let me just... Oh, I got him wrong. Oh, what is wrong with me? Okay, so who's the first one that said it? Yes, I wrote it. This is my mistake. Let me see who got it first. Peter got it first. Oh, see, I put Gloria Stewart. Don't ask me why I put Gloria Stewart. I mixed up Gloria Stewart's character and Lillian Bond. I feel like an idiot because I should know this like the back of my hand. Yes, Gloria Stewart played Margaret Waverton and Lillian Bond played Gladys. So, my bad. I am wrong. I knew it when I saw that everybody was putting Lillian Bond. I go, oh, I got that wrong. So yes. Peter's now got 4 points. Paul Hamm 4. WWM 1. Thank you guys. And listen, it happens to the best of us. Hillary Swank, Molly Ringwald, Lauren Bacall, Duck Dodgers. What's going on, Duck Dodgers? Where you been, my friend? Cool. I'm thinking like Dino. What, Gloria Stewart, man. Woo. A little, you know what? In the movie, Margaret or Gladys? There was something. Listen, Gloria Stewart in the movie looked more glamorous and more seductive, but there was a playful, sexy Lillian Bond in this movie that Oh, that I loved. So I think it was, I'm more of a Lillian Bond in this movie, believe it or not. But anyways, okay. So with that said, yes, I'll move on to the next question. Here we go. My mistake. Like I said, it happens. Anyways, what the heck is wrong with me? Okay. Which member of the Femme family is locked away and considered dangerous? Which member of the Femme family is locked away and considered dangerous? Do you guys remember? Alluring, says Sirius James. Just alluring. Well, look at you. You know this movie, don't you? You know this movie, Paul. I mean, Peter. Peter and Paul. Saul. Saul Femme. Saul Femme. And boy, do I love it. Dino minus 1 point. Yes, Duck Dodgers. Well, no. I just goofed it up. Listen, when I go through so much work, you got to be sure and 100% sure. But listen, it happens. I think in all the trivia nights, I think that's the first time that's happened. So anyways, Peter, Saul Femme. When he comes and makes his appearance towards the end of the movie, oh my God, he plays it. He plays it to a T, right? I mean, come on. So Peter, you got 5 points in the lead now. Mrs. Rochester, Uncle Stabby. Yeah. And not Better Call Saul. No. LOL, Uncle Stabby. Yeah. Margot Robbie, Black Roses. Yeah. I wouldn't mind being, no, that don't make no sense. Anyways, I'll shush. Okay, so on with the next question. Here we go. We got more questions. 8:41. This is about time where we cut for a commercial break. And I say, are you enjoying this station? I mean, are you enjoying this channel? How about thinking of becoming a member? Become a channel member, either on Patreon or through the channel. There's a join button. And so help support this channel. You can help support it in many different ways. You can give it a thumbs up. Please do. You could comment after the stream. It's funny. The review I just did the other day, I begged. I said, please, the 30th commenter will get something special for me. I got 3 comments. It's so hard to do. I rack my brain. How crazy. But think of the chat, more active, thumbs up, comments, join the channel, all the links that are below. Do whatever you can. Share it if you can. Even if you got 5 people on Twitter, share it. Maybe one of those people might end up liking it. Do it. Super chats. Any way you wish. Now back to the program. Here we go. Emmy and Dave Plouffe talking paranormal and ghost stories. Art Bell, remembering Art Bell and Coast to Coast AM. Tomorrow night, 1996. So here we go. Next question. You guys ready? Pyromania, brought to you by Baba Yaga Chicken Leg Barbecue Sauce. Serious James. I know, I almost thought, what happened? Did the chat die? Did the chat croak? Pyromania. Yes, Francis. Next question. This is easy. Let's see who can get it first. You don't have to have Twitter, Francis. It's all right. I'm just saying those people who do. You can share it on YouTube. You can share it on Twitter. You can share it on Facebook. You can share it on, there's a link. Anyways, why am I going on? What is the primary setting of the movie? This is easy. Go for it. Don't do Twitter or Facebook. You mean X? Yes, X. Right. I still call it Twitter. I know you do, Connie, and I much love, appreciate it. And I get it, man. People don't like social media. I understand you guys. I understand. It's only for the relevant people. An old house, Peter. Oh, my God. You know, I should have eliminated that question. I was trying to throw an easy one out there. Listen, Paul Hamm gets the point. A house is fine. It's an old mansion. It's an old, creepy, isolated mansion is what it is. But if you want to go simple, like house, that's fine. 5 points to Paul, 5 to Peter, 1 to WWM, the backseat of a car, a doghouse, the castle. Yes, the castle. It is somewhat of a castle, although it's more a villa. The dining room, the conservatory. Okay, so next question. Let's keep it going. Why is Morgan particularly dangerous when he drinks? Morgan is the butler. Why is Morgan, played by Boris Karloff, why is Morgan particularly dangerous when he drinks? What happens when he drinks? WWM, I'm losing. Yeah, you are. Yeah, you are. That's what we love. That's what we love, old dark houses. I do, Sir James. Paul Hamm. So, yeah. Hold on. Giving it to Paul Hamm, yes. Let's do the time warp again. He attacks. He gets violent. Yes, yes. Paul Hamm comes in first, taking the lead with 6 points. Peter Wernicke, you still got 5. We're just one behind. Yes, he gets violent. He gets very violent and uncontrollable. There was a point where I think the three men are holding them back, and he's throwing them off like they're flies. I mean, it's so, yeah. And he's strong. He's strong. He can lift 100 pounds over his head easy while running. He goes on a rampage, mean drunk. Yeah, all good. He takes off his clothes and runs around the old dark house. Black Roses, you. He starts to tap dance and play the accordion, says CM. I like that. That's not bad. I'll accept wrong answers too. Bring him on. Duck was thinking the same thing, Sir James. He gets romantic and flirts, takes all the women home. Tap dances, sings, putting on the Ritz. Young Frankenstein. Yeah, yeah. I was in the pool, says WWM. What the? Anyways, okay. Okay, so next question. Let's keep her going. Let's keep her on the run, in the mood for love. Here we go. Okay. What is the connection between the old dark house and Frankenstein? What's the connection between the old dark house and Frankenstein? I'll accept one or the other. How about that? It doesn't matter. If you do two, if you come in first and do two, there you go. I was going to say, are you going to do a wrong answers night anytime soon? Yes, yes, only wrong answers. I am. Maybe next week. I think I'm going to change it up, something different next week. Paul Hamm. So there you go. Mary Shelley, Karloff. I would have accepted Karloff. Both have Boris, but they both have the actor Boris Karloff and the director James Whale. Yes, he also directed Frank. So yes, there you go. Anyways, good job, Paul Hamm. 7 points to you, 5 to Peter, 1 to WWM. Member 1 year, Karloff, James Whale, Boris. Both have Boris, Karloff, Whale, Dr. Pretorius, Sir James. there, both movies. Thank you, Francis. I'm losing too, says Harry Scott. Oh boy. Oh boy. Well, you know, it's I'm not gonna say it's bound to happen, but it's all good. Yeah, no, you know. But good job, good job. Continuing on. Who played the eccentric and religious Rebecca Femme? In the movie, who played the eccentric, and I mean very eccentric, and religious Rebecca Femme? Okay. The Rebecca Femme, who played her? Huh? Oh, she was a mean woman. She played that part so well. Yes, Venom. Dinner time, no pickled onions, thank you. No pickled onions, nope. I love it. The dinner scene, she was awesome in that. The pickled, oh my God. Anyways, okay, well, Paul Hamm seems to be taking it away now. I'm fine, who is Penny? Never seen this movie, Duck Dodgers. More. Good job, Peter, but Paul Hamm with 8 points. Keeps him piling them up. There we go. Ava Moore, yes. She goes way back before movies were created. Yeah. Anyways, but boy, yeah, her at the dinner scene, she was so eccentric. Like, she was almost like a witch. Like, what do you mean? You know, very, very cool. I loved it. She was mean even at dinner time. I love it. Yeah, and they would pass it and she would eat like so quickly and... No pickled onions. Loved her character. Very, very cool. Okay, let's keep this going on a roll because I've got plenty more questions. We're still got half an hour. I got plenty of questions. So, you ready, you guys? Let's see if anybody remembers this. Okay. So, what year does the film take place? Not when was the film made, but when does the film take place? The year. Let's see who gets it. It was mentioned. And the book. So, you know. But, yeah, it was mentioned. So. Was it 1932? No, that's when the movie was made. But in the movie, MR, no. No. I mean, it could have been 1932, but no. Is nobody going to know this? 1932, 1936, 1933, 1872. Duck Dodgers, no. This was mentioned in the film, and it's also in the book. I'll say WWM, you're close. WWM is very close. You're getting warmer, WWM. You're getting warmer. Who's going to hit it first? 1927, Peter Wernicke. Peter, 1692, CM. Yeah, CM, you need another name a Giallo film, whatever we did. I forget what I called it now. Gave that. Okay, Peter's now got 6 points. Paul has 8. But yes, it was 1927. 1927 is when the film takes place. So there you go. Good job, Peter. Good job, Peter. Way to go. Way to go, my friend. I'll ask you at the end. I'll take a poll at the end for what we're going to do next week. It's going to either be another trivia night of a classic film, or an only wrong answers trivia night, or caption this. So I'm going to put a poll up at the end, and you guys will decide what we do next week. Okay, so next question. Here we go. Yeah, see, you know what? Hold on. See, I might have got this wrong. Hold on. Okay. In which country is the old dark house located? In which country is the old dark house located? Again, it was said in the movie. That was a toughie. Well, I gotta make some of them tough. There's a book also. I'm back in college studying, says Duck Dodgers. Yes, the book is Benighted by J.B. Priestley. A good read. You might want to check that out. Well, there we go. There we go. Now Paul Hamm, now with 9. Peter Wernicke with 6. WWM with 1. Scotland. Scotland. Of all the places on the earth, Scotland. No, it's done in Wales. Wales. Estonia, says CM. Romania, Black Roses says. But most of the people got Wales, Wales, Wales. My feed is slow. How can your feed be slow, Duck Dodgers? Am I like going, the next question is, Wales is the answer. Paul M. Minus 2, Duck, Harry Scott says. You mean just lagging a bit behind? You know what? The thing you could do if you're on your phone or tablet, I say this all the time. On the right side of your screen, double tap it and it pushes you forward. Double tap it, it pushes you forward. So if during the stream, say you think your internet is a little bit slow or something, if you're on a phone or a tablet, double click with your finger and it'll bring you to the front. Don't pause it, but you should be able to double click and it'll push it forward. Anyways, just a little hint. Wonderland. I was second to Paul, so that's a win. Sirs James, Peter, Diddle. Some people answered in the chat before you said the question on the stream. The answers appear before we hear the question even start. Yeah, this is the thing with the trivia nights, you know. This is the thing with trivia nights. I don't. So listen, it's going to be either only wrong answers or. I mean, I don't know what to say about that, but. Okay. Next question. Here we go. Is anybody going to know this? Okay, here we go. Why was the movie considered lost for many years after its release? Why was the movie considered lost for many years after its release? Let's see if you guys remember this. Okay. Why was the movie considered lost for many years after its release? Very interesting fact. Francis, mine's sagging. Duck Dodgers. Oh man, my behind is sagging, CM. You're quite the comedian tonight, CM, huh? I usually get a serious CM. I love it because of legal issues. No. It was yanked by the studios for underperforming and was shelved. Wow. Okay. So maybe nobody knew this. It was in someone else's attic. The original film burned. I don't think that was necessarily 100% it, Black Roses, but because nowhere did I see that it was burned, but nobody else is saying anything, and that's the closest because that could have happened. Put back in the wrong case, legal. You guys are all saying all things that you know what? Well, Connie Clary, there we go. I'm going to accept Connie Clary's answer. Connie gets a point. You guys were saying burn, put away in a case. Technically, The original negative was destroyed. I didn't put, why didn't I put exactly why? The original negative was destroyed and no prints were believed to exist until one was found in the 1960s. But the original negative was destroyed. Was it by fire? Because if it was, then Black Rose's, the film, they filmed it over with Frankenhooker. But it was, this movie was lost up until the 60s. Can you believe that? Can you believe that? Can you believe it? But in most of all the articles I read, it just said was lost because it was destroyed. I didn't hear anything about the fire. So there. So I'll give it to Curtis Harrington found it. Paul Hamm. Very cool. Thank you, Paul Hamm. I mean, thank God somebody found a copy, right? But 30 years and nothing was found. But thank you, Rebecca Femme. Thank you for Roderick and so stuff. Okay, very cool. Very cool. Okay, so let's move on to the, you know what? I'm going to go to the next next questions here. Let's see. Next question. Who was the producer of The Old Dark House? I mean, come on. Who was the producer of The Old Dark House? Who produced this dang thing, huh? Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Are you ready to go? Tell me what you need. Tell me needed to know. What? 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 Dino's going off the deep end. Get reel it back in, Dino. Limely. No. Serious James. No. Oh. I'm gonna accept that. Listen, Paul, everybody, I'm going to accept Sears James because I know who he meant. Paul Hamm says Francis McCloskey. Anybody care to pronounce it correctly? Sears James says Sears. Now, okay. Paul Hamm put the full correct name, but I've got to give it to Sears James because he tried. He said Limely. It's Carl Limely Jr. Yes. Like Paul Hamm just typed it out there. That's the proper spelling, Carl Limely Jr. So, but I will listen, I'm giving it to Sears James because I know he knew what it was. It was way off. I love the spelling. Here's a Limely. Not even Limely. It was Limely. Limely is what it was. But Carl Limely. Love you, Sears James. Good stuff, man. Okay, so there you go. Sears James on the board. So, but Paul Hamm still in the lead with 9 and Peter behind with 60. Peter behind, what? Yeah, close is expectable. Way to go, Sears. Yeah, I mean, it's a tough name to spell. I mean, that's for dang sure. So good job, Sears, with your first point. There you go. Yeah, moving on. Here we go. Listening. He did The Most Dangerous Game in King Kong. Yes. Oh, he did a crap ton. And there was some behind the scenes stuff going on with wives and stuff like that. I think we talked about this during one of the Frankenstein discussions or something. I forget, but yeah, there's a lot of history there. A lot of history. There's a lot of history going on. Next question. You're welcome, Sears James. The opening credits of the film has a unique introduction for Boris Karloff due to his previous role in a famous horror film. What does the introduction state? Let's see. Dude was a founder of Universal Studios. Yes, Peter. Yes, exactly. And again, I forget. It's an intricate story on who he married and all that. But let me read this again because hopefully somebody gets it. The opening credits of the film has a unique introduction for Boris Karloff due to his previous role in a famous horror film, which we all know. What does that introduction state? Get close. Get close. Close enough. Played a monster, ghoul. No. There's a certain key two words. It says he is the same actor who portrayed Frankenstein. No, it doesn't. It's trying to take him away from the Frankenstein character. Please turn off your electric devices. You know, you almost have to see the film again. See what happens when I do hard questions? To see the opening credits, because it's stated right there. When it introduces Boris Karloff's character, it states a certain something during the movie, just to make people understand it's Boris Karloff playing. Okay, I'm just master of a thousand faces. I'm just going to say it. I think this is one that I'm nobody's going to come up with really. It says, and the answer is, I'm just going to give it. Wait, what was Lon Chaney? Yeah, exactly. Karloff, the mad butler in his celebrated characterization. In quotes, Karloff, the mad butler in his celebrated characterization. So, stumped you a little bit. Again, that was a tough one. So, point goes to Boris Karloff. Lon Chaney was the best, a true genius. Was he the best? I'm going to move on to the next question in a second. Karloff's last picture was Curse of the Crimson Altar. Yeah, Lon Chaney, I mean, listen, for his time period, he was one of the best over time. I mean, you've got Vincent Price, you've got Boris Karloff, even Bela Lugosi to some extent. But yeah, I mean, listen, Lon Chaney, I think better than Lon in the long run. But yeah, I don't know. That's a tough one. Anyways, Karloff's last picture was, okay, I read that already. Okay, next one. Here we go. This one should be easy. What is Saul's deadly fascination in the movie? What is Saul Fem's deadly fascination in the movie? Pretty easy. I go from a very difficult one to a very easy one. Who's going to get the point? Frankenstein. Fire. Yeah, there we go. You guys all got it. Firestarter. Yes. Palm gets hit. Paul now has 10 points. It is fire. He's a pyromaniac. And he has an obsession. He's obsessed with fire. So there you go. He's a pyro. They all made each other better. Yeah, they all did, Harry Scott. Good point. One without the other, I mean, all kind of worked off each other, even played in movies together. I mean, you know, you can go Christopher Lee and Peter Cushing too. Who is the greatest horror icon of all time? I mean, that's something we could sit here and debate forever, right? Lon Chaney was great. He was great for his time. He was, I'd have to look at the full picture of their entire career and from then until now, and who do I think is the greatest horror icon out of those classic actors? And it's a tough one, and I'm not even going to say. I mean, it might be between Boris Karloff and Vincent Price. Although Bela Lugosi, a lot of people put him at the bottom of the list. You know, I just don't know. But Lon Chaney's up there. It's a tough one. It's a tough one. Beavis and Butthead, fire, fire, fire. Paul came to play tonight. Yes, yes, 10 points. But Peter, good second place tonight here so far. CM, boring. Wait. What's boring? They all had strengths and weaknesses. What's boring, CM? Please tell me. I need to know. Vincent Price and Boris will always be recognized as the greatest. And those were the two that I kind of going with Paul Ham trivia icon. Yeah. Paul Ham won't show up next week if I do caption this. But it's all good. I'm just joking. CM, boring. I'm trying to think. Please explain. Either I missed something or I want to know what's boring. Please. Tell me. I can't move on to the next question until you type it in. What is boring, CM? Let's all wait for CM to explain to Dino what is boring. That stream is boring. That's what's boring. No, I'm curious. Was it one of the Boris, not boring? Oh, what the heck? You had me going, what? Is one of the actors boring? Maybe I said Bella and you're like, oh, Bella's boring. How can that be? But okay, Boris, not boring. Okay, CM, I gotcha. Thank you. Things like that would drive me nuts. Okay, anyways, let's move on to the next question. Oh my gosh. Suspense. By the way, tonight is Sherlock Holmes night. I feel like a Sherlock Holmes night. So get ready for the overnight being a very good Sherlock Holmes stream. Good sounding episodes. So there you go. Next question. The Old Dark House wasn't the only collaboration between director James Whale and writer Ben W. Levy. Which other horror film did they work on together? Hopefully you recognize the writer Ben W. Levy in another iconic horror film. And you could put them together in what they made together. James Whale and writer Ben W. Levy. Which other horror film did they work on together? Dino will track you down. God dang autocorrect. I know listen, I hate autocorrect. It just drives me nuts sometimes. Okay, do you guys... know the next, what other horror movie did they work in together as I swing my legs? What? Oh, no, Peter. It's one of those iconic films, not Frankenstein, though. Not Frankenstein. Not The Mummy. Harry Scott, not The Mummy. So we've eliminated Frankenstein, The Mummy, and Dracula. It's not Frankenstein. It's not The Mummy. It's not Dracula. Which one is it? There's only Diamonds Are a Ghoul's Best Friend. Yeah, CM. Decline of the Western Civilization. Thank you, Paul Ham. I knew Frankenstein might be the first one. Sir James Bride of Frankenstein. But yes, no, it was The Invisible Man. It was The Invisible Man, 1933. They both worked together on their film. So there you go. Paul Ham with 11 points. So very cool. Very cool. Good job, Paul Ham. Oh, my God. It's 9:13. Creature from the Black Lagoon. Okay, let me go on to the next question. Okay, here we go. Ernest. Well, should I do that one? Okay, let's see if somebody gets this one. I'd be curious. Charles Laughton, we all know Charles Laughton, right? The great great actor in this and many others, and even in old time radio, Charles Laughton, who played Sir William Porterhouse, is famous for directing which 1955 film? So Charles Laughton, who played Sir William Porterhouse in this movie, is famous for directing which 1955 film? Does anybody know that? Do you know? Thank you, Connie. Definitely please hit that. Oh, good. Oh, well, it's Paul. I'm impressed. Listen, Paul, I went out of my way to get some questions here that were different and harder. And man, you know, it was Night of the Hunter. Charles Laughton directed Night of the Hunter. Very cool. Night of the Hunter CM. Night of the Hunter. Swashbuckler, says Harry Scott. Frankenstein, third cousin once. Kane Mutiny. He should have directed 20 more movies. Cobra, Malibu, Unlimited. I like the 80s Avatar, but yet you came to an old school horror trivia night. So very cool. Well, you're like me. I love the 80s too. So he should have directed more than he did. Cobra. I agree with you. But Night of the Hunter, Paul Hamm. Very cool. Good to have you here, Cobra. The film was not well received and he never directed again. Isn't that a shame? Charles Laughton, poor guy. House of the Wolfman, LOL. Okay, so let's move on. Let's do another question. Let's see, which one? I'm trying to see. Okay, here's one. Let's see if you guys like this question. Here we go. The sound design in the film uses the relentless sound of rain to create a claustrophobic atmosphere. What other sound is recurrently used to heighten tension, especially around the character Morgan? So we get the rain. What other sound is recurring using heightened tension, especially around Morgan, Boris Karloff's character, when shown in Peak? Oh, they didn't even need to go on anymore. Oh, geez. Okay. Hey, John McKee, what's going on? Good to see you. Paul Hamm with his 13th point. Thunder, wind, 100. It was the wind. Every time Morgan's character would be in the scene, not only do you get that rain coming in, but it was always with a... So you would get that sound of the wind howling through the cracks of the house. And it just created that heightened tension and feeling. Creepy, unsettling wind. Yes, Venom. Very cool. Listen, I can still do another one for the fun of it. Crickets burping. Yeah. I said it first, Dino. Sirs James. Did you? Wait, hold on. If you look on the screen, Sears, it says Paul Hamm says it first. Rewind just a little bit. That's why I do my screen, because I believe you, Sears James, on your stream and you're looking at the chat. YouTube does this where it shows up. It shows your name first because it's your channel and it puts you ahead. But for me, I have the true what's coming in. So that's why I decided I'm putting the stream, the chat on the screen so people can go back after and look at it. So if you look at this stream afterwards, or even go back a few seconds now, you can see that Paul Hamm came in first. So thus, that's why I did that. Anyways, you were right there, though. Whenever the wind breaks, look at who's next to you. It did it to me before Sears. Yeah, again, you guys have to dismiss that. It's the reason why I put the chat up on the screen for Trivia Nights, because it's a YouTube thing. If it's your channel, it's going to show something totally different for you. It's going to put you ahead. Don't ask me why it does that. It's a YouTube thing. But, not just Duck, not just Sears. It's happened to a lot of people. And some people got upset over it. And that's why I had to put it up on the stream. So, anyways. Well, let's do another. Let's see. Okay, so here's another question. In the 1963 film, also titled The Old Dark House, is related to the 1932 version in what way? So how is the 1963 film, which is also called The Old Dark House, related to the 1932 version? What way is it related? Or how is it different? Let me put it that way. How is it different? Oh no, I tried to. They really got upset. Yes, Duck. Couple people never showed up again. They got pissed off. And I had to explain to them. I wish I could show you on my screen, which comes from, and I looked into it, and over time you figure it out. You know what I mean? So, what's different about the two films? There's a big difference. There you go. Venom. Venom gets the point. Yes, yes. I'm surprised, unless maybe some of you guys haven't seen the 1963 one. It wasn't set during the storm. No, it was a comedy. Let me see. I wrote it all down. The 1963 film is a comedy remake and not a direct sequel of any kind either. Comedy, totally. Venom gets a point. First point. Well, there. Needless to say, take care, CM. Peace. Hopefully, we'll see you with me and Dave Plouffe tomorrow for Art Bell. Yeah, I'm going to end it there because it's getting towards the bottom of the hour and stuff. Hopefully you guys enjoyed these questions here. It is a bad remake. Yes, Paul Hamm. Listen, they turned it into a comedy. I don't know what they were thinking. Anyways, thank you. I'm going to end the stream. We had fun. Another Saturday night game night in the books. I think next week. Listen, I was going to poll it, but I think I'll just go ahead and do maybe it's going to, you know, we haven't done name a, how did I title that? Name a giallo film title. I have to look back and what, but we'll do something different for game night next week. Maybe something totally different, but look forward to it. I think I'm going to take a trivia night off and do something maybe a little bit different. Caption this. I don't know if people were getting, it was getting old for them. I don't know. It's the views weren't coming really. So, I mean, I'm like, well, I'll go back to trivia for a little bit and then come back to caption this. But we'll see what we do. The name Dark House. Hope everyone has a great evening. You too, Harry Scott. Surprise you. Yeah, I'll surprise you guys. I'll think of something special for next Saturday for game night. So, anyways, make sure you hit that thumbs up on the way out, and please comment after the stream stops. Let me know what you thought of the game night. You know, it always helps. And Sherlock Holmes tonight, all night long, some good sounding shows, and Hopefully you guys enjoy. How can you not enjoy Sherlock Holmes? I felt like a Sherlock Holmes night tonight, so that's why I'm going to listen. So anyways, battery about to. Oh, and congratulations, Paul Ham, with 13 points. And Peter, you got 6. I mean, listen, for second place, you were doing pretty damn good, man. Paul Ham just, he's like that Jeopardy, you know, guy that just isn't going to miss a question most of the time. Had fun. Thanks, Dino. Thank you, Venom. Really appreciate it. And with that said, I'm out of here. See you guys.